Hello viewers, SuperGT here. Thank you for joining me for another video. Okay, Gran Turismo Sport Daily Races. It's been a very long time since Alsace has come up in Daily Races. But there it is. I mean, yeah, what even is it? It's a very weird track. It's a very, very weird track. That's perhaps the reason why it hasn't come up so much. Looking at the fastest times, we're looking to try and get a low 51. Now, as I said, the track hasn't come up all that much very recently. If ever, to be honest. So, we have to go out and set a very shocking first lap, which was actually quite worryingly off the pace. It's about 3 seconds off. So it would take a bit of learning, this circuit. It is a weird one, as I've said 1,000 times. Now we came around on our third lap here to get a semi-respectable 52.6, but it probably wouldn't be enough for me to be anywhere near troubling pole position in the next race. Did a couple of more slower laps before destroying my car against the barrier like that. Okay then, race number one. Now, what I have to say, right, is as you can see the grid there, what I have to say about this circuit is it's a very weird one. It doesn't really fit the script when it comes to fictional circuits in this game. It's very, very different compared to all the other tracks. But as you'll see throughout the course of this video, it actually produces very good racing. But an example of some bad racing is about to happen right here. As we go past the Greek guy in the Kindermobile, with this fast sweeping left into a tight right. And as we just hit the brakes here to go into this corner, there's a bit of contact and we are sent spiraling wide. And there is a very angry Greek guy right now with a 3 second penalty. Just to kick the video off, hasn't taken long for a penalty to appear, which is always great, isn't it? Goes defensive on the right and then he slows down. Coming to the next corner, I have my wits about me. See him come flying back up the inside. Okay. And now he's going to try and force me very narrow into this next right-hander. And all manner of mayhem is about to ensue here. With SR downs left, right and centre and above and below. Everywhere. You see them right behind me. Very many angry people. We've got a very angry Greek guy. And we've got a Turkish guy on one bar connection. So this is a group that I'd probably rather escape from, if at all possible. And that seems to be happening right now. As we come into this very tight hairpin here, difficult corner, and you see I've vaguely misjudged it as we go in. And the very, very big group now. 6-7 cars in that group. Very happy to not be part of it, if I must be honest. We go over this crest, and then back down the hill towards the final chicane on the lap. And what I would say is that when you hook together a lap around here, it's actually quite a satisfying feeling. It's just not that easy. You just do have to take some time to get used to this circuit. But okay, first race, started fourth, finished third. Setting a 52.3 on the final tour just then. Okay, we'll take that. Now this guy obviously wasn't happy, so he left a rather sarcastic message. Now normally I don't really reply to these people, but well, why the hell not? Let's just put him in his place. Right, anyway. Let's have a look at the replay, see what happened. So here's his perspective. Come into this corner. It just seemed like a racing accident to me. 3 second penalty. So obviously he might be very well aggrieved by that, but that's the game's fault rather than mine. But there you go. Doesn't really excuse what's about to happen next as pulls over to the right hand side, slows down, and then luckily you see just pull out last second. It's always good advice to pull out if you can. And well, this is a bit dirty. I think that's the right word, really, isn't it? Actually doesn't do too well out of all of that. And then coming through here, the Beetle actually really hooked up. The Beetle's actually a very good car for this circuit. But anyway, we improved our time here in the next qualifying session to a 51.8, so dipping below the 52 barrier. Let's see if that puts us in good stead for this next race. Wilfredo Flowers, nice to see you again. So I love the fact that my typing here, like, it already says hello, and then viewer. It already knows what I want to say. So yeah, hello viewers. Okay, race number two. Starting third. Let's see if we can go perhaps one better than we did in the previous race. We started fourth, ended third. Can we start third, finish second? And progressively make our way up the order. That is what we're trying to do today. In this one, pulling away already from the Beetle just behind. And we're coming up here to the fast sweeping left-hander. Then you're going to go down this little dip into this right-hander. Tricky corner. And I will run through my quickest qualifying lap later on in the video. If you want some tips on how to get a 51 lap time. But for now, looking at the back of this Lexus. And the Lexus seemed to be an early contender for car of the race. As pretty much everyone was choosing this car. But I think the Beetle is actually the go-to car now, if not the FT1, which is the car in the lead at the moment. FT1 always good around handling circuits. This track has a fair amount of very long winding corners. For example, this one, but also this big boy about to come up. This can rival Turn 8 at Turkey. I mean, just look at this thing. I'd love to see an F1 car go flying around this kind of corner. The Italian there giving me space. And we're going to run side by side now into this tricky narrowing little hairpin here. I'm going to go around the outside and I'm just going to get given the space. It's good racing actually between the two of us. And we've gone up from third into second. Good little fight that. And actually, as I said earlier, you know, this track actually produces some good racing when you can learn, once you get to grips with it. Excuse the pun. Actually have some good races here. And I've actually been enjoying this race. When I first saw it come up, you know, Group 3, Alsace, I thought, I don't know about this track. There's perhaps a reason why it doesn't come up all that often in daily races or FIA, but it's actually been a decent race circuit. I actually quite like it. It should actually come up a bit more often. But I'll just say it again for the benefit of reinforcing the title of the video. It's a weird track. It is still a weird one. There's no doubt about that. Okay, so it's up to second place. So normally this corner here can be one where you might have to defend because it is preceded by a fairly long straight. The guy behind you gets a good exit out of turn one, then you may well have to defend, but on this occasion not having to do so. Dipping two wheels narrow, don't really want to do that. I've got a poor exit here. See on the radar, there he is as we look behind. Just on my left-hand side, I'm going to have to leave the space on the left as we go into this right-hander. That puts me into a bad compromised position on the way out, so he's going to be very close coming into this one. Probably not close enough to go for this move. Very difficult corner this one. Easy to misjudge. Easy to go too wide on the way in, as I've done countless times. And on the way out, actually, for that matter. But we progressed to the beginning of lap three, and I was just speaking about defending into this following corner. And it looks like that's going to have to be the case this time around. As you see here, the Italian very close behind, less than 3/10. And he's just poking his nose into the radar. So I'm going to go slightly to the right-hand side here. Make sure I get down, slowed down enough into the apex. Be patient through this apex. Lots of long corners here at Alsace. I do recall the time that I called this track Alsace, and everyone went ballistic in the comments. That is a good way to improve user engagement on YouTube, is to pronounce something wrong, and then everyone will surely correct you in the comments within 5 seconds. So it's great racing here at Alsace, isn't it, everyone? So coming to this next left-hander over the crest, as we mentioned, got to be really patient, wait to get on the power, using the full extent of the circuit, make sure we can get on the power as early as possible. Then we've got the Big Banky Boy V2. Which one's better, the Maggiore, Big Banky Boy, or this one? I think this one's pretty extreme, if I must be honest. The leader, beginning to pull away, he's long gone. Driving very comfortably in that Toyota FT1, and he's managed to gap us quite convincingly at this point of the race. With only one lap to go. And up the hill, very difficult corner, and it's probably my weakest corner on this circuit, if I must be honest. So down the crest, down towards the final chicane. Easy to get this one overcooked. And we've actually taken it quite nicely. Conservative through the first bit to give us a better line through the second. Running the wall on the exit as close as possible. Trying to break the toe a little bit there crossing the line with a 52.5, not the best lap. Ideally, we want to be low 52s, if not into the 51s during the race. On the exit there, using the full extent of the circuit plus the kerb, are we going to have to defend into this corner coming up? Not quite. He's only half a second behind. So not close enough to go for a move. Don't quite have to defend it yet. Look for the markers on the left-hand side. He actually brake just as they begin. Again, waiting for that late apex. Powering out to the outside. Back over to the right to give yourself a better run into this long left. And then just coasting slightly back off the throttle to get the nose to bite. You can see they just drops off slightly, taking a poor line. At the end of this race, managed to consolidate our second position, so we did actually manage to improve from the previous race. And it was actually a good battle, that, with the Italian. Pretty happy with that one. So a good race, good fight, and I very much enjoyed it. Finishing second on this occasion. The FT1 there going very strong, but finishing in second this time around. So we find ourselves back in the menu. We've had two really solid races. Perhaps I should continue with the Lexus, as it's given me some solid results so far. But no, we're going to be really stupid and try a car that I've never driven in a very long time and see how it goes. So go with the Acura NSX. Don't ask me why. Don't ask me why I'm trying to manhandle this beast around this circuit. You see here, that's hopefully not a sign of things to come. That was a pretty shocking corner. This car is actually quite... you have to be very tentative on the power, let's say, on the exit of the corners. Otherwise, it does like to do a 180 on you. And, another example of 180-ing as we scrape off the wall. So not the best warm-up, not the most ideal preparation for race number 3. So we're going to kick things off here in the NSX. Let's see if we can do what we did in the previous race. So we've got the same two people in front of us. We have a Greek driver behind who may well try to avenge his countrymen from the first race. But at the same time, he might not care. He might not even know who he is. Right, coming down to this 90 degree right, break just before the banner, just before the curb on the left. I'm waiting to get on the power. On the exit, easy flat right here. Dip down, and then look for the markers on the right, braking just before you get to those, as you pretty much get to the top of the crest. Lexus fairly slow off that turn. Oh, actually, that car behind caught me by surprise. Didn't expect to see him so close so quickly. And then this Lexus going very, very wide, as he seemed to do in the previous race, actually. But getting a better exit and managed to slot in firmly ahead. So it's going okay so far. A little bit late on the brakes. I think there's a tiny tap of contact. And just tip two wheels beyond the curb. You see there, just sliding the car a little bit too wide on the inside. And unsettling this fine motor into a semi-spin. Down to fourth. Not good. So we've only gone backwards here. So this could be quite a tricky race from here. When you're stepping into a different car, they haven't driven so much. You're going to be a couple of tenths off per lap, and when you're at the front end of the grid, towards the front, you need every little last tenth that you can get. So things can get quite tricky, as they are here, and I'm not in the slipstream of the cars ahead. But to put in some fairly solid couple of laps, mid-52s, not amazing, not going to set the world alight, but somehow managed to catch back up to this Greek driver. But it was this mistake here. You see they're just drifting a little bit too wide, too confident on the brakes, and the gap just opened back up. The Greek guy and the Italian having a little bit of a fight there through the final couple of corners, but it wasn't enough. Came through to finish fourth, so not too great, but actually in the end, a couple of consistent laps. Could have been better, could have been worse. There you go. Let's take a look at this live stream, right?
A 0.5 is coming.
A 0.5 is coming is what I said there, and it was true. Because this lap coming right up is about to be a 51.5. So let me guide you through it as we come up towards the first corner. You're looking for the 50 board, which is the last one, breaking just before it. The first half of this corner is just seeing yourself into the apex, and then second half, powering out as early as you can on the power to the outside. And you've got this long left, looking for the big arrows on the left. first one there, you're braking just pretty much just at the first one. Coasting mid-turn, let the car meet that apex and then get on the power over to the right-hand side. And again, being patient, waiting for that late apex. Getting your left wheels inside the white line and powering out to the outside. Going back over to the left, looking for the banner or the curb, braking just before them. Get yourself into that apex, power out to the outside as early as you can. Easy flat this one. Go over to the right-hand side. Again, looking for that marker on the right, the big arrows, braking just before them. And again, patience. Wait for that late apex. Power out to the outside once again. There's a theme developing at this circuit. Long corners, late apexes, patience. And again, through this very long, big Banky Boy V2, looking for that late apex, being patient, coasting mid-turn. A good lap so far. We're hooked up. And we are setting purple sectors. Nice and hooked up there. Very easy to overcommit into that corner on the brakes. Just be nice and patient. Fast left-hand sweeper up the hill. Very difficult. Just got to keep the throttle on mid-turn to keep the car nice and settled. Over the crest. Couple of corners left to go. Braking just before the curb on the left-hand side, which is there. Just before it. And actually go a little bit wide here. You want to go a little bit more to the right here on the entry to this final left. But not too bad. Probably lost a tenth in that final couple of corners. Across the line we go, 51.5. Lost a bit on that final corner, but that'll do. Take a look at this final lap. I'll leave you with the commentary.
Oh, who's that? Well, there's one position for free. Okay, triple lunge, as you do. How? Oh, I could get fourth. Okay, I'll take fourth then. Chat's going mental for that triple lunge. How did I finish fourth? Get in there, Lewis. Fantastic drive, mate. Miracles do happen, mate. Triple kill.
Okay. Laying down the triple kills in that live stream. But now we come back a day later to try to consolidate some more wins. Now, I found real comfort in the Lexus RCF. I don't think it's the quickest car. By this point in the week, it was no longer top of the leaderboards. On Monday morning, it was top. And then everyone seemed to choose it. But it isn't the quickest car. I'm pretty sure that title either goes to the FT1 or the Beetle. One of those two cars. And we have a whole horde of Beetles just behind us, which is a rather ominous thing. So we're going to basically just try to nail four consistent fast laps and see if we can win this race. We got Ollie just behind us here. How we try to keep him at bay. It's going to be really difficult to try to break the toe. You need 3/4 of a second. As long as he stays within that, then he's going to find it rather easy to keep up with me. You're going to be gaining at least a couple of tenths per lap by being in the slipstream. So I basically have to accept that it's going to be a defensive race. Although at the same time, as long as I just nail the corners, I don't have to necessarily defend. It's just one of those races where you're on the edge the whole time and you just know that any mistake might see you lose the position. You just have to be very consistent and calm, I think is the right word. So into the hairpin, keep it nice and pinned. The Beetle really good through there. The Beetle's really good through the... I know, it's just the long flowing corners. The nature of this track is like that. There's lots of that type of corner. The Beetle seems to do very well through those kind of corners. Down the hill, first lap. Still in the lead. Doing well so far. And 25% done. Still got three more laps left to go. Plenty more opportunities to bottle it just yet. Across the line though, end of lap one, in the lead. Okay, good start. Into turn one, lap two, a little bit wide there, on the power the best we can, straighten the car up a little bit to get a better drive on the way out. So Ollie very close this time around, 3/10
And from the previous race, that's about close enough to start thinking about defending here. Although the Beetle, not quite as good as the RCF here in a straight line. So not actually having to defend on this occasion. But that's a good good thing to know, how close he has to be before he can start going for that move. So he's going to have to be closer than 3/10 coming out of this corner. Coming out this time, he's firmly within 3/10. Like just over 2/10 this time. Definitely closer this time around. And by being a lot closer, the slipstream is going to be more powerful. So I'm going to have to defend this one. I'm going to go for a more central line coming in. He does look for the move, but he's not quite close enough to complete it. So having to go narrow, and therefore having to slow down a little bit more on the apex of the corner, compromising the exit. And Ollie there just making a bit of a mistake on the exit of that corner. Very small mistake, nothing major, but enough to see me go through this one uninterrupted. But now, again, he's not close enough, so just going for the normal racing line and just taking the corners as you would. This is the final lap, though, so running out of opportunities to go for this lead if he wants to take it. Through this long right-hander, 4/10 ahead going in. Didn't quite take it perfectly. Maybe apex a little bit too early and lose maybe 1/10 through that corner. Again, not close enough for Ollie to go for this move, though. This one, keep it nice and pinned on the apex. And then just 3 more corners left to go on the circuit. This was my weak corner, and on this occasion not taking it very well at all. And now he's right on our left, he's on our left hand side. He's going to swap over and try to go for the right. I'm going to keep it nice and narrow, so there's basically no chance of that happening. And it was a strong defensive race, but that's what it had to be. So we're going to come through to win this race, which was actually a very, very, very close one. Very, very close one. I had to really get my elbows out there and defend it. But defend it we did. And we thankfully secure a victory around the Alsace village at long last. Well, we go again. No time to rest. We go once more. And if you thought that race was good, this one was even closer. I didn't perhaps drive it as well in terms of outright pace, and therefore was on the back foot a little bit more over the course of this one. We're going to fast forward to lap 2. Lap 1 went by uninterrupted, and again, looking at that radar, this one was very much a race of tactical positioning, and it kind of has to be, as you saw in the previous race. But this one was, I had to really get the tactics out here, as it was really a case of trying to send the car behind the wrong side. So here, just making sure he goes to the left and just lifting just to keep him on the left. So I was noticing that he likes to go for a late switchback, so just keep him on the wrong side basically by lifting. And this is the thing, you know, you're always learning about different opponents, what they do and what they don't do, what they don't like and what they do like, and then you're just trying to put them into the position that they don't like. Here you actually get a good cutback, testament to the Beetle power. Big shout out to the boys back at the VW factory for lying about emissions, but also for producing such a good downforce car in the Beetle Group 3 car. Love it. Okay, there have been a little bit of an overshoot. Not too much to worry there though, because we can still resume the lead and resume our racing line. Lap 2 here, up the hill. Is he close enough? Yes, I would say, because he's right behind us on the radar. So we're going to go over to the right-hand side, and again, you see the lifts there, tactical lifts, to keep him on the left. Because in the previous race, he tried swapping over to the right last second, which is not what we want. Okay, end of lap 2, half the race done. It's been a really close one so far, very close here. Again, cover the inside, tactical lift, keep him to the wrong side. And he managed to get the undercut here on the way out, which was a very good undercut. Just missed the apex slightly. Took advantage. But this is a drag race between the Beetle and the Lexus. You see the Lexus does have the legs. I've got the favour of the left-hand corner here. And then into the right. I'm going to run narrow as possible. And just give him basically a car width. No more. And manage to just sweep around the outside. Keep the position really, really, really close racing here. Now coming through this one, again, he's right on us. I'm going to make sure he goes to the left, and he does. The wrong side, no way of going around the outside there. And I've defended so much that he's actually invited a third player into the battle in the form of this Dutchman. And that's actually, you know, you might think that having more people to defend against isn't a good thing, but I find that defending against two people is actually easier because the two people will start fighting each other a lot of the time. You know, if you're isolated in a 1v1 with someone, they can have their full attention on you. Whereas if there's a third player just behind the pair of you, then the guy behind you has to think about two things: attacking you, but also defending against the third guy. Third guy there making a mistake and just dropping down two positions. So that didn't really last too long. But we still have about 0.7 seconds here. So a bit of a healthier margin, could we say, compared to the previous race, or at least the first half of this race so far. Because the gap was seemed to be always 0.4 or less in the races that have just happened. Across the line we go, 0.75 seconds here. You see how slow of a lap time that was, 52.999. At least about a second off the pace because of all the defending. It just shows you how much defending does slow you down, but if you keep your position, then you need to do it. And it is only a 7.5-minute race. But at the end of it, we did all we had to do once again and came through the final corner to get another victory. And actually, that one was very hard fought for, just like the previous one. But I would say this one was actually even more difficult to achieve. But I would say I'm quite pleased with how I was defending, just the defensive knowledge there of getting the other car to go to the wrong place. And well, there's the result, another victory, which I was very happy about. But there we go, everyone. Thank you so much for seeing through another video. Hope you enjoyed it as always. Give us a sub if you do enjoy that one, or if you did enjoy that one, should I say. Twitter, Instagram, Twitch, all linked below if you want to give us a follow. But in the meantime, take care. I shall see you all very soon. Goodbye.